Hello, fellow gamers and crafters, Tokwak here with a new episode. I know it's been a while, and today I wanted to try something new. I needed some line of sight object, and also I wanted to prepare something that my players could use in a Pathfinder campaign. And so I came up with creating a wagon, and in the old style I tried to make it a bit modular so it could have multiple uses. I know the video is a bit different this time, so I learned a new editing software. That's also why the video took so long to come out. I hope it shows, and I hope you like the build, and see you later. We start off with some simple shapes, and the biggest one is a 50 by 60 by 110 block. And what I immediately did is I trimmed off the top. It has a radius of 35, so this is what I go with. And we're gonna need four wheels. I already prepared a door, and from the cutting you will probably have some leftovers, and let's see what we can do with them. But the first thing that we do is I take a toothpick, roughly estimate where the wheels will go, and I'm gonna pierce a couple of holes in the bottom. The next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna trim out the inner part and cut off 1 centimeter from the bottom. I then used the toothpicks, pinned it all together again, and started trimming off the front and the back. Also from the inner part, I cut off a piece that would serve as a front and as a back door. Here I decided that my wagon could also use a window on the side, so I cut one out. Remember that you do not trash the part that you cut out, because we can use it later. Now I could start texturing my wagon. And for the deeper grooves I used a pencil, and for the finer wood structure I used the dull side of my cutting blade. My wagon is missing something, because this is the front of my wagon, and I want to give the minis a seating area, and therefore I took an extra part that I could find and started crafting one. And with the base done, it's time to take care of our wagon. I glue in the front and the back wall. And then I weigh it down so that it can dry. Once it's dried, I put on the back door. And while all of that is drying, I'm starting to build the first of my accessories that I can put onto it. I want to build a chimney, though I've cut out this tube and this cone, and you can already see how it will fit together to become a chimney. I just trim it to size. And with a lot of glue and a toothpick, in the end it will all go together. I also have an adapter at the bottom so that it goes nicely together with a domed roof of the wagon. Yeah, and with a lot of glue eventually it will fit together. To attach it to the wagon, it's quite easy. I poke in a hole with another toothpick and then it fits nicely in. Once the door is dried, I can also glue on the door handle. And on the front side, I know it's hard to see, I put on a little window frame for the front door.
I also wanted to build an elevated platform on the roof so that a mini could nicely stand on it and take a sun bath. And to make it fit perfectly, I used the toothpicks, pushed them through from inside, and marked my board on where the toothpicks will eventually end up. Yeah, more glue, more toothpicks, and eventually it's gonna fit. And in that manner, you could build any kind of accessoire you want to have on the roof of your wagon. I brought in a couple of tiny pieces that I could use as ornaments. For example, I have a rope and I have a lantern that I can glue on. And I also want to create an advertisement board that I can put on top of my wagon. Tiny piece of leftover XPS, two toothpicks, and a bit of fantasy can go a long way here. I show here really is just an idea. You could as well build something entirely different. At this point, I felt like my wagon was still missing something. So I went back to the old sprue and clipped out some 90 degree anchors. And then I took some longer XPS pieces, trimmed them down to two round rods. And I trimmed down also a couple of toothpicks. And I started building myself a ladder. I fixed the plastic holders onto my wagon and I made sure that the ladder also fits in. I also put in a tiny bit of another toothpick in the front so that I have a wooden nail where I can hang a board from. For the board I just used another tiny piece of XPS and a garden wire plus some glue and you got yourself a tiny board. I wanted to kick up the modularity by a notch, and I used two beams that I had used in a previous project, plus a couple of extra pieces. And I wanted it to look like it's a farm cart, so you could load all sorts of veggies and fruits and whatever items on it. I first started tri-fitting everything together, and once it fit, I started gluing everything in place. Now with everything built, it's time for the color. I have my Mod Podge and it's mixed with black color, and I give everything a really good base coat. That helps to make it more sturdy, and it also helps if you have built things from different colored foams to tie it all together. The next step for me is to take some orange and give it a really heavy coat. This is a basic layer for my wood color. And then I add some gray dry brush over it. I dry brush it quite heavily. And you can clearly see the effect that it has on the pieces. I wanted my wagon to look like an old circus wagon, so I took some yellow and some green, and I decided that the color is a bit too bright on its own, so I took some gray and mixed it in to dull down how vibrant it really was. And then I carefully applied the color. I needed to check how much I really applied, because I wanted the wood color from underneath shines through. I wanted it to look like an old wagon that has been on the road for many years, and somebody tried to fix it up by giving it a new paint shop, but also this was a couple years ago. And it's really a mix of painting and dry brushing the color on. I ended up painting every second beam that I had previously created. Once I was happy with it, I came in with a green color, and also this green color got a bit of gray, and the same here. I wanted to give all the metal colors a rust color, so I mixed some orange, some non-metallic silver and black. And the good thing about my rust color is that with the non-metallic silver particles it has a bit of a shine, and I quite like it, and it's super easy to make. and I threw that color onto all my metal parts. So basically the hinges for the ladder. The window frame and my tiny lantern. And also the nail that I had on the front of that, as I did on the axle of the whole wagon. Then I had my sepia wash and I applied it really liberally. You see, it's kind of a really muddy color and it ties everything together. Just throw on as much as you can. With my advertisement board, I really took my time. I took my finest brush and I loaded very little color on it. And then I kept going over and over the letters until they finally began to show up. The last thing to do was to glue in the toothpicks into the bottom of my wagon. And then it was time for the glamour shots.
So that's it about the build. I know it's a bit on the low-tech side using all the toothpicks. You could use magnets and that would also work perfectly fine and you can modify it to whatever you like. If there's something you particularly like about the build, leave it in the comments. Otherwise, like and subscribe if you haven't yet. And now it's your turn to craft.